Welcome back, everyone. We're trying to stay on the mark in this falling airship. Galahad got separated from Percival because of a messy kitchen. Always keep your kitchen clean, and then the order won't be split in half. Thanks for all your support on this series. Keep smashing that like button if you enjoy. I want to see more. We're going to stop for a little picture viewing. It's two chefs. My favorite two chefs. I'm going to inspect these two chefs, even though I'm supposed to stay on the mark. I'm bon voyage. Okay, Percival, I'm having picture time. It's really fun. You got to, like, calm down. In we go. Let me in. Can I get in? There we go. Knob City. Knob City. Look at those flames. The thing is on fire. This is like a... It's like a floating coffin. What do I have got? Oh, guns a-blazing. Here we go. A little bit of dining room action. Ooh!
Lafayette, what's going off?
Bad things.
The damage from the explosion is getting worse. How long can you stabilize this ship? Not long, monsieur.
What you can, Marcus.
Good work.
Just give us a few more minutes.
It won't let me take cover behind these chairs, but I can't shoot them up. Trying to go for the headshot there, a little high, I guess. Got him, there we go. As I recover my health. Should I try to get this guy out with a grenade? Anybody else in there? I feel like there's one more dude.
I'm pushing forward. I got you
covered. Oh god. It's a guy with a freaking pot on his head. Pot man. Get out of here, pot man. Smoked him out and he's like, oh god! Reload the gun, Galahad. Gotcha. Not gonna mess with me. That was absolutely awesome. I'll take your shotgun. Rock and roll, baby. Look at all these bathroom, man. I need this sort of style in my life. Isn't this the gun I have right now? Oh, this is the two-shot revolver. Let's mix it up. Just gonna mix it up to keep things fresh for you guys, alright? Dead bodies everywhere. These compartments are- Ah! What? Oh my god. I'm so sorry, the three-crown coach gun.
There were rebels in the cabins. I've cleared them out, and I'm continuing my pursuit.
Understood. I'm heading to the stern of the ship, and we'll sweep back towards you.
Can I get in here? Oh, maybe I'm supposed to go downstairs? I guess so, okay. What did that sign say? Gamer room, sweet! Where's the PlayStation 4s? What kind of games you got in here? This don't even look like games. Get out of here, that's not a game. Cards, okay, that's a game. All right, little roulette, I see what you're saying. What is back in this case? That is freaking epic, okay. So we're gonna head down another level, it looks like. This time to the unnamed room, but there's broken stuff, which means they're near.
Ooh! Lafayette!
Going!
We lost multiple gas cells. The ship is uncontrollable.
I'm just a wrecking crew right now. I don't even care who stands in my way.
Galahad! Hold your fire! There's no time, Percival! We have to stop him!
Trust me, Grayson. Listen to me, lad. Stand down.
You have no idea who you're dealing with. We are not the enemy!
Then prove it! Stop this madness.
No. Not as long as the company is allowed to carry on and obstruct it.
They won't. We'll see to it.
It's too late.
Sebastian! Friend. You don't have to do this.
Oh my god. Game over. We are all dead. The heck?
Gray, calling Percival. Come in, Percival.
Galahad, acknowledge. Gray, Sebastian. Oh, take that black water, buddy. Otherwise, you're not gonna make it. 15th day of October, and things have gone to hell, literally. Like, I'm half expecting Satan to pop out. We are in rubble of a monstrous degree. The ship has crash-landed. Somehow we've survived, thanks to our magic water. And it is a mess, but those fire flames, this scene, the mood it sets is just strangely beautiful, despite the destruction.
Damn it.
This guy's on fire, it doesn't look fun. Oh my god. It's like the worst way to go down. It's gotta be hot in here. Give me some ice cubes. I need a slushy.
For God's sake, respond.
Izzy, I'm here. Izzy, can you hear me? Shit.
Let's go. Here we go. Is this Percival? Percival! Not him. I mean, sad for this guy, but good, it's not our brother. Our mentor. I like this scene, like all the stuff, I legit can't believe I'm playing this. It looks so good. Holy cow.
Lucas,
video games, man.
We lost contact with Percival and Galahad.
What is this? Another communicator?
I need any able-bodied knight in the vicinity of the Crystal Palace to respond.
Lady, no one is believed to have survived the crash.
It's me.
Gray? Gray, respond. Where the hell are you?
Get this off, Percival. Save the day. Galahad just doesn't seem to have the strength. Come on. Hulk, I need you. Make this an Avengers movie and let's get moving.
Do this alone. You two head up to the council.
Gray.
It's all right, is it? I'll join you in time for the succession.
Mes pensées sont avec vous, monsieur.
Condolences. Sir Percival was a great man. The best of us. I took the liberty of keeping these aside. I know it is not standard protocol.
Must be Percival's best piece. I'm just kind of wiggling it in my hand. I can't do much with it.
Grace. Do not blame yourself for what happened. Let this cloud pass.
How can I? He was my mentor. My brother.
So he was. But concern yourself with the upcoming solemnities. The rest can wait.
Too many questions remain, Alistair. I intend to find answers. Mallory's death will be avenged.
Do not fall prey to dark thoughts of retribution. That way madness lies. Come. The council awaits our presence. Lord Hastings is on his way from the United India House. He wishes to thank you in person for saving his life and the lives of all the other people on the ship. The United India Company owes you a debt of gratitude.
For over six centuries, the knight called Sir Percival sat with us in Brotherhood. He saw entire kingdoms perish, and others equally transitory take their place. He saw the rise of the half-breeds, and was relentless in their pursuit. To all these things he bore witness, because he was blessed by this. The Grail, the black water that courses through our veins. The bond that unites this order. The elixir which heals all wounds and extends the life of natural men. Yet it cannot ensure immortality. Now, Sebastian Mallory, once Sir Percival, is dead. There is a tradition of bestowing a knighthood in our order. Only on the occasion of the death of him who bears that honor and burden. Generation after generation, new knights have taken the names of their hallowed predecessors. We are assembled here today on just such a solemn occasion. From blood of old. The Grail will give new life. Do you, Marie Joseph Paul Yves Rock, Gilbert Dumotier, Marquis de Lafayette, swear to uphold the most noble precepts of our order? You pledge to give your life in service to our righteous cause?
With all my heart and soul.
Drink. May the Grail give you life beyond life. By this communion, you are bound to our sacred order. Henceforth, only your blood shall replenish this vial. May the black water serve you well. Always use it wisely. I dub thee Sir Percival. Servant of our great king and knight of the Round Table. Rise, Sir Percival, and assume your rightful place at our table. Guards! Remove Sebastian Mallory's body from the council chamber and take him to the crypt. This council is now called to order. Let the terrible tragedy which has befallen us serve as a warning to those who would defy the mandates of this office. The late Sebastian Mallory did not perish in the fight against the Halfbreeds. No. He died a victim of his own heedless enterprise and the negligence of those sworn to uphold the highest standards of duty and sacrifice. And to what purpose?
Lord Chancellor, I must have...
Public buildings destroyed! Innocent citizens placed at risk. Incalculable damage done to United India Company property. It is only by the mercy of Providence that an even greater disaster was avoided. All this while not a single rebel was taken into custody. On the contrary, by their rogue actions, the knights in question may have done the enemy a great service.
The Lord Chancellor perhaps speaks too harshly. He would do well to remember that Sir Percival's force did uncover evidence of a rebel effort against the...
Circumstantial evidence! Mere supposition, all of which resulted in a deplorable calamity. I will hear no more of the matter.
With respect, Lord Chancellor.
Sit down, Sir Galahad!
With respect! I, too, have lost a friend. More than a friend. A brother. You do great wrong to sully his name in such a manner.
You dance on the very edge of insubordination, Sir Knight.
I am apprehensive of my responsibility in this affair. Yet if the same circumstances should present themselves, I would do exactly as I have done. As Mallory wished.
My lords! Sirs! The rebels have ambushed Lord Hastings' carriage. He and his escort are trapped on the Westminster Bridge.
All knights to arms! Protect Lord Hastings! Let's eliminate these godless rebels once and for all.
Sir Galahad, this matter is not yet over. Someone will yet answer for Sebastian Mallory's death!
Of that you can be sure.
Arm yourselves and take defensive positions on the bridge.
Galahad, your command.
Let's go.
Sir Galahad! The carriage carrying Lord Hastings was hit in the middle of the bridge. We're not sure if anyone's alive.
Lucan, Egrain, Percival, with me.
Hastings may still be alive. We must reach him.
Things have gotten serious, guys and girls. I'm going to pause it here because this was a whirlwind of an episode. A whole lot of cutscenes. I just sat back with my mouth agape. Sebastian Mallory, he's not... Their names are different, which I think is weird, but he's dead. He's gone. He didn't... I thought we'd give him a Blackwater bath and maybe work some magic, but apparently, nope. And also, Lafayette has been now introduced into the knighthood as Sir Percival, which is kind of strange and awkward, but he's one of the boys now, which is pretty cool. Hope you guys are pumped for the next part. It should be a lot of fun as we blast our way through this bridge and continue to find out what this order is really all about. Thanks so much as always. Drink some hot chocolate. Until next time, we'll see you all later.